Ang mga pananaw at opinyon ng pag-uulat na mag-uulat sa programang ito ay hindi ang pangunahing posisyon o pahayag ng pamunaan ng organisasyong ito.
To our fellow HNI members and everyone, here now is the Orasyon Peralta against COVID. God our Father, we come to you in our need to ask your protection against the COVID-19 that has disturbed and even claimed lives. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Protect the medical experts that they minister to the sick with competence and compassion. We pray for those affected. May they be restored to health soon. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in this trying time to work for the good of all and to help those in need. We implore you to stop the spread of this virus and to save us from our fears. Grant all this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Apply to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not despise our petition in our necessities. But deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and blessed Virgin. Amen.
Amen.
Our Lady, Health of the Sick, pray for us. Saint Raphael and Archangel,
pray for us.
Saint Rock,
pray
for us. Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. Saint Pedro Caluso, pray for us.
To our fellow HNI members and everyone, here now is the prayer for the protection for hands inclusion. God our Father, we implore you to ask for the enlightenment and rescue, the repentant success of the organization Hands in Inclusion in us. We ask for the repentance of the group from the false judgments of other people, including its former members. Rescue us from all sense of power and deliver us from the lesson of revenge that comes from the devil. Keep us in putting God first, whatever is the religion of their core team, including the founder, while being inclusive to all those who are in need of inclusion, especially persons with disabilities, LGBTQI+, people confused with their gender, ethnic groups, and poorers of the poor whom you also love. Help us to stop ourselves from manipulation of other people and resorting to unjust grudge, conspiracy, and violence, which might affect the people we are trying to serve. We beg for its founder and his core team to be enlightened to see the lies behind the false doctrines and impure and violent motives of the false accusations we make and believe, and open the eyes to the truth of the pride that we hold. Help us humble ourselves, O Lord. Help us to realize that fear, envy, anger, and unforgiveness comes from Satan, and he may stop whatever pride that he is holding. Please allow us to know ourselves a child of God. We also pray for those people who are blamed by Hands Inclusion Filipinas to repent from the sins they are guilty of without resorting or believing in any false accusations made by either them or any enemy they encounter. Forgive us from our accusations in any form and from all the wrong timings in your eyes, the organization. This we ask in your name. Amen.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of the sick, pray for us. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Saint Rock, pray for us. Saint Lorenzo Ruiz, pray for us. Saint Pedro Alonso, pray for us. Saint Clare of Montefalco, pray for us. Saint John the Baptist, pray for us. Our Lady, help of all Christians, intercede for us. Saint Monica, pray for us and our family and friends. Saint Augustine, pray for us and our family and our friends. Saint Michael the Archangel, Saint Benedict, Pope Saint East of Death, and Pope Saint John Paul II, rescue us from our unintended wrongdoings. God the Holy Spirit, have mercy and change the heart of everyone. All organizations, all the people who formerly worked with the organization who made terrible mistakes, and those the people who took part in the conspiracy to falsely accuse anyone and hands in danger. Amen.
Amen. Today, our topic for Open Arms is Disability and Health Information for Family Caregivers. So, welcome to another episode of Open Arms. I'm Millicent Makose, and ito po ang ating i-discuss for today. Kung meron ho kayong family member who cares for someone with a disability, bata man or matanda, when you combine personal caregiving and everyday needs, this can be challenging. So here in this presentation, we will share information for family caregivers, such as anyone who is watching. Any one of you could be a caretaker of someone na may disability. To help you and those you care for stay safe and healthy. Excuse me now. Here are the caregiving tips for families with persons of people with disabilities. Today, I will discuss general caregiving tips that provide families with information kung paano tayo mananatiling healthy and positive. Positive na optimistic, that is. These tips can be used to address many family issues. Information, support, advocacy, empowerment, care and balance can be the foundation for a healthy family, and these will be appropriate no matter what the challenge. First, we must gather information about your family member's condition and discuss issues with others involved in the care of your family member. Kapag nagbigay kasi tayo ng impormasyon, this will help you make more knowledgeable health decisions and improve your understanding about any challenges na pwedeng iharap ng family mo. Notice how others care for the person with special needs. Kaya dapat maging aware tayo sa signs of mental or physical abuse. Now, how can you get support? Family members and friends can provide support in a variety of ways and oftentimes want to help. That's why you must determine if there are big or small things they can do to assist you and your family. It is also recommended that you join a local or online support group. There are several of which, so Viber chats, WhatsApp, Facebook chats, anywhere. These support groups can give you the chance to share information and connect with people who are going through similar experiences. A support group may help combat the isolation and fear that anyone can experience as a caregiver. Also, don't limit your involvement to support groups and associations that focus on a particular need or disability. Dahil meron ding local and national groups that provide services, recreation, and information para sa mga people with disabilities. Friends, family, healthcare providers, support groups, community services, and counselors, ang mga ito ay ilan lang sa mga pwedeng makatulong sa inyo at sa family niyo. How can you be an advocate? Be an advocate for your family member with a disability. Caregivers who are effective advocates may be more successful at getting better service. Huwag mahiyang magtanong. Great with commercial. Kung meron kang family member na may disability na naka-wheelchair and you want to plan on a beach vacation, find out if the beaches are accessible via a car, ramp, portable walkway mat, or other equipment that can accommodate people who use wheelchairs. Inform other caregivers of any special conditions or circumstances. For example, if you have a family member whose disability has a latex allergy, remind dental or medical staff each time you visit them. Document the medical history of your family member with a disability and keep this information current. Napaka-importante nito. Because anytime when you have to monitor your family member's condition, there are some changes that you might encounter, and pwedeng they might have outgrown this allergy or what, or meron siyang na-develop na something similar. So this has to be kept updated from time to time. Make sure your employer understands your circumstances and limitations. Discuss your ability to travel or to work weekends or evenings. Arrange for flexible scheduling when needed. This is why pwede rin sa inyo na may mga kasamang may special needs, mga you're caring for someone with disability, you could also ask for a work-from-home arrangement. Become familiar with the Americans with Disabilities Act, the Family Medical Leave Act, and other state and national provisions. Know how and when to apply to them to your situation. Let's also be empowering. It's because we can focus on what you and your family member with a disability can do. Find appropriate milestones and celebrate them. Kung mayroon namang magtatanong sa inyo about the family member with a disability, let him or her answer when possible. Kapag ginagawa niyo to, this will empower the individual to engage with others. When appropriate, have time na turuan ang inyong kapamilya na may disability to be as independent and self-assured as possible. Also, you should keep health and safety issues in mind. Another important thing is, alagaan mo rin ang sarili mo. Take care of yourself. When one cares for a family member with disability, no matter how physically strong he or she is, it will still wear him or her out. That's why you must stay healthy for yourself and those you care for. Work hard to maintain your personal interests, hobbies, and friendships. Huwag mong hayaang kainin ang buong mong sistema ng caregiving, that is, it's not going to be healthy for you or those you care for. Balance is key. Allow yourself not to be the perfect caregiver. Set reasonable expectations to lower stress and make you a more effective caregiver. You may also assign some caregiving tasks to other reliable people. It could be your friend, your sibling, your colleague, na kung kailangan mo ng break, lalo na. Regarding breaks, short breaks like an evening walk or relaxing bath are essential. Long breaks, on the other hand, are nurturing. Arrange a retreat with friends or get away with a significant other when appropriate. Isa pa, wag na wag baliwalain ng any signs of illness dahil when you get sick, see a healthcare provider. Bigyan mo na rin ng pansin ang iyong mental and emotional health. Kapag naaalaga mo na maayos ang sarili mo, makakatulong din ito sa taong ikaw ang nagbabantay at nag-aalaga. Exercising and eating healthy also are important. And of course, keep balance in the family. There are family members with disability that may require extra care and attention. Take time for all family members, taking into the account the needs of each individual. Ito, halimbawa, importante rin para sa parents ng isang anak na may disability to also spend time with each other and with their other children, whether they are near, especially if they are neurotypicals. Consider respite care. What is respite? It refers to short-term temporary care provided to people with disabilities so that their families can take a break from the daily routine of caregiving. Lalo na kapag mayroon silang outing or get-together, this will be helpful, itong respite. People with or without disabilities can stay healthy by learning about and living healthy lifestyles. Now let's go to emergency and disaster preparedness. Mahalaga rin na ang mga people with disabilities and their caregivers make plans to protect themselves kung sakaling maka-encounter sila ng isang emergency or disaster. These can strike quickly and without warning at maaari nitong maka-force ng mga tao to leave their home or be confined in their home, mga stranded, lalo na pagka maklakas sa ulan at sa sobrang lakas, babahain yung first floor or minsan second floor pa nga in our case eh. For the millions of Americans who have disabilities, emergencies such as acts of terrorism and disasters such as fires and floods, itong floods na tinutukoy could also happen in the Philippines, lalo na pagka may malalakas na bagyo. These present a real challenge. Here are how we can find more information and resources of caregiving, including tip sheets and links to organizations and networks that can provide support. Resources from Administration and Community Living, Department of Health and Human Services in the U.S., finding help for yourself and a loved one, and benefits for children with disabilities. So now, before we quickly wrap this up, ongoing pa rin po ang ating inkunihan para sa Oplan, Loli, and Ulysses. We are still accepting any amount of donations para sa mga nasalanta ng mga bagyong Loli at Ulysses sa Bicol at sa Cagayan. If you have the time to send any amount of donations, you may send that amount to this number na naka-flash sa inyong screen. 0908-638-8270. I repeat, 0908-638-8270. So, ayan. You're about, we just have finished discussing yung sa paano mag-alaga ng mga persons with disabilities, ng people with disabilities. Meron na tayong na-share na health information for family caregivers. This is not uncommon, lalo na dito sa Pilipinas. Yung mga family members, sila rin nag-aalaga sa kanilang anak or kapatid or pinsan or pamangkin na may autism or Down syndrome or any other mental or physical disabilities. Maaari ring kailangan nilang bigyan ng assistance yung mga visually impaired relatives nila. Or pwede ring may cerebral palsy ang kanilang inaalagaan. Oftentimes, these people with disabilities need some assistance in differing degrees. Sila rin kasi ang tutulong sa kanila to become independent at some point. Although, in some cases, meron talagang people with disabilities na kailangan ng alaga at attention ng kanilang magulang or kapatid or any relative na capable enough. So, if you could have any tips that you can share para itong pag-aalaga sa mga persons with disabilities can be made less stressful, you can comment them down below. Pwede rin sa YouTube live link natin or rather the comment section. It's because when you are tasked to take care of your relative na may disability, it can be really challenging. Such as the case of yung mga hindi na makalakad from the waist down because of any accident. Or pwede rin the person that you might care for could not move his or her limbs from the neck down. Pwede yan din yung reason. Although in some cases, these people with disabilities could have the capability to make their arms or legs move again at some point through intense therapy and rehabilitation. Although in some other cases, it's going to be a lifetime condition. That's yet another example of how caring for people with disability, whether it's inborn or due to an accident, could be challenging at varying points. So another example here, yung ibang case kasi ng autism, there is this really delayed mental development of the patient, of the kid, yung inaalagaan. Bukod sa tuturuan sila about the basic ABCs and tasks, pati paglalakad and discernment, they have to be taught by their caretakers. Or minsan, their caretakers would also act as their tutor. Then, every now and then, importante rin ang pag-monitor sa gamutan ng mga people with disabilities. Regardless of their condition, whether it's physical or mental or whatever, it's what I have most been curious about. Pati yung pwedeng cause ng allergy ng mga may disability that I discuss in this presentation. Whenever naman there's an improvement in the condition of the patient, importante rin talaga ang milestones, such as when the patient had acquired paraplegia or quadriplegia and was finally able to move his or her arms or legs, it should be a milestone. Or pwede rin kapag yung isang visually impaired has learned the basics of Braille, it should also be considered a milestone. And pwede rin if you have decided to study FSL or Filipino Sign Language in order to more efficiently communicate with your deaf or deaf-mute relative na kailangan ng special attention, that should also be a milestone. In my case, I have yet to personally learn FSL because I sometimes communicate with a cousin of my relative sa mother side. She has a condition wherein hindi siya makarinig, hindi siya makasalita. She communicates through Filipino Sign Language. So madalas, what I do in order to communicate with her is sulat-sulat lang muna. I couldn't do the basic gestures of FSL properly. Lalo, I don't have the time kasi to study it. Siyempre, kailangan din ng balance, such as when you are considering respite, yung sa respite, it means na meron pwedeng mag-assign muna mag-alaga sa patient whenever the rest of the family has some important celebration to attend to. So that's it. This is how our open arms went for this first Tuesday of March in the year 2021 with the topic Disability Health Information for Family Caregivers. Siyempre, bukod sa pag-aalaga sa people with disabilities and how they are going to need assistance at some varying degrees, importante rin ang overall well-being ng mga caretaker, whether it's the spouse of the patient, the parent, the sibling, any close relative. Importante talaga yan. We have to maintain this good balance between taking care of your loved one na may disability and self-care na rin overall. So, this has been Bilicent Makuse. Gusto ko lang munang mag-shout out before I go to my parents. I'm specifically my dad's former colleagues. Thank you then for being there na. Kinamusta niyo yung dad ko when he was starting to take medication and all of it until he has decided to retire para yung kanyang recovery from a medical condition would be smoother. Let's still keep him in our prayers, by the way. I would also want to give a shout out pati sa mga teachers ko in high school sa REPC Balikpapan program. REPC is in Pasig City. Gusto ko lang ho kayong kamustahin. Thank you for the guidance. Although we didn't get to see each other frequently, I still remember all of you po, mga ma'am, mga sir. Hopefully in a better time, we will all meet up again. I want to visit the campus pagka pwede na ulit ako lumabas-labas. So, this has been, again, Bilicent Makuse for Open Arms with our topic, Disability Healthcare Information. I mean, Disability Health Information for Family Caregivers. And here at Hands in Inclusion, we believe in a God first and truth first inclusion and society. And here at HNI, we all put God first. Have a great evening, everybody.